in human society of this thing that's called the state. What is the state? The state is this organized bureaucracy. It is the police department. It is the army, the navy. It is the prison system, the courts, and what have you. This is the state. It is a repressive organization. But the state, and well, you know, you've got to have the police, because if there were no police, look at what you'd be doing to yourselves. You'd be killing each other if there were no police. But the reality is, the police become necessary in human society. Only at that juncture in human society, where it is split between those who have...
How you doing today, Cindy?
Doing all right.
PNN is in the house here to support Mario. Wrongful death. They need to be held accountable and liable for gross negligence on our families and our communities. You have anything to say about that?
Yes, they do. They need to be held accountable. You know, they've been doing this for a long time, and you know, what they want to do is they want to intimidate you and scare you out of the city so that you won't expose the corruption that's going on. You know, they murder party. You know, this is not a case of excessive force with no force to be. You know,
yeah.
You can't just go and pick who you want to pick on, kill them, you know, and then plant a gun on them and say, oh, I'm going to parole you, I'm going to go back to prison, knowing that that's not the truth.
And how has this impacted?
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you all for coming out. What we're doing here is really, really important. As a lot of you know already, my brother, Mario Romero, he was murdered in front of his home by a Vallejo police officer. At the time of the killing, not only did they refuse to give him medical care and allow him to just die, they took his body away from the scene. They brought in a pellet gun and many other crimes they committed against him. One of the most significant things about my brother's case is that our family, as well as witnesses in the community, witnessed the whole event from the beginning to the end, okay? And unfortunately for a lot of families, they found out about their loved one being killed sometimes days later, okay? Right now in Vallejo, we have a problem with corruption. Corruption, the planting of evidence, okay? Everybody in America, we're supposed to have the right to due process, which means that we'll get the same rights as everybody else. However, in Vallejo, California, when you are killed by a police officer, you are no longer an American citizen. You have no rights to anything. Your family, they have no rights to your body, to your property, even to an explanation as to why an officer would kill an unarmed, innocent man.
We know what time it is. It is time for us to unite where we're in the community as workers on the street. They're coming after us. It could be you. And I'm here to change that reality because we want a future for our children. And anyone who is Mario's nephew, when Mario was murdered, he was only 4 years old. He sat on the steps of the Vallejo Police Department. What am I going to tell my cousin, Mario's daughter, when she cries for her daddy? And I remember that. So the whole community needs to wake up and unite. We need to commit ourselves to support each other, whether you're in the union, longshore, service employees, teamsters, workers, any of these unions must come and connect the dots, because the community is under attack by the police and the city government. They are linked. We need to rely upon our own strength. We need to develop an organ of protection for our people, an organ of protection.
The South lost that war, and we thought black freedom a fact. But then the Ku Klux Klan, they went on the attack. The Northern Capitalists, they put us back in the sack. 100 years later, we rise and react. We fight segregation. New laws there now. They said that freedom we took, here's some of it back. Uncle Jesse, Uncle Roy, Uncle Martin, they swallowed that smack. King received praise. They gave him a plaque. But Malcolm X spoke for a revolutionary tract. Higgins for defense, you and Bobby, clack, clack. But then the government went on the attack, murdered the Panthers, our warriors in back. Not quite. 4 years later, the coming of Barack, elected the first American president who just happens to be black. But for the rest of black people in the ghetto across the track, finds that America still ain't cutting us very much slack. Young Isaac Grant shot point blank in the back. Henry Louis Gates, he just
let them stand alone like many people in the Bay Area are comfortable with letting the Romero family stand alone. No, we gotta unite everybody. Unite all the unions, unite all the families. Unite every person affected by this capitalist system, which I'm sorry to say is everybody. It's a class system that must end. So it takes a class solution. That means we have to shut it down and organize things on class terms for ourselves. So Leopard Black and Brown stands for that. We say shut it down. Can we hear a shut it down like the longshoremen would shut it down? Can we hear a shut it down?
Shut it down.
Shut it down.
Shut it down.
We shut it down.
Shut it down.
We shut it down. They shoot it down. We shut it down. They shoot it down. We shut it down.
They shoot it down. We shut it down.
I seen the video. I seen the bullet holes that was inside the car and couldn't believe that our officer would do that to two people that got their hands up. This could be any of us. The ILWU is here to support this family in any which way of matter. We're here to support the community. We're looking for the unions and more unions to support the community going forward and any crisis that the community have, that if they don't have no one, they could come to our union and to just be behind them. That's all they want us to do, be behind them. They see us in solidarity, they gonna have more people in solidarity, we'll have more unions in solidarity, and then they can ask the question.
I just wanna thank everybody for coming out and supporting us. It's important for everyone to know that this is not a case of excessive force. You know, it's not a case of excessive force with no force Michael. Needed. You know, the Vallejo Police Department, they need to be held accountable for these murders. You know, they think that they can murder us and get away with it. They slander us in the media. You know, automatically it's a gang-related crime. You know, when they murdered my brother, they told people, oh, it was a drive-by shooting. You know, a lot of lies coming from the Vallejo Police Department. You know, no truth. And, you know, they're bleeding the city dry. And they want more and more and more, you know, but they can't even give us mandatory drug and alcohol testing and psychological evaluations. You know, when an officer jumps on the hood of a man's car and shoots and claims that he's afraid, one has to wonder what's going through the mind of that.
Coming out to support us, Mario Romero is my son, and my oldest son that they murdered. Each day I look at the fact that how could these people, these police, get away with what they have done to my son. They ruined my whole son's body. They ruined my son's life. They killed him. They took away someone very special to me. Someone that all of his life I was there for him. He was there for me. He was my strength. He picked up the boxes for me. He came and got me when I called, boy, come and get me. They took something very valuable away from me. My son was a very, very talented young man. He wrote music. He did his rapping. He sung in talent shows. He did a whole lot for the community. He went around with people that he did not even know, and he would give them a helping hand. And for me to see what the Vallejo Police Department has done, they never even used no protocols because they did not know who he was when they killed my child. And for a mother to have to go and wait that long, almost a month and a half, to be able to go and see my child's body with all of those holes in every part of his body. It's really a sad, sad situation. Each day that I wake up, I have tears in my eyes because that was my child. My child didn't deserve to die. My child was begging them. A witness across the street told me. He said, we got our hands up. Please don't shoot us. Please don't shoot us. You wouldn't want to do this. He begged and he begged. And that man, that monster, killed my child.
Foremost, I'd like to state that, you know, Christopher Dorner proved that there's no such thing as a good police officer. I'm explaining to you exactly why. Because if there was a such thing as a good police officer, there wouldn't be a Christopher Dorner at all. First and foremost, I also like to state that everything I heard here is actually going towards the right direction. Only this, we need to defend ourselves. We have no other choice. The revolution ain't coming. It's not going to be something you just see marching down the street. That's not the reality. The revolution is here. The revolution starts with Mario Romero, and every 36 hours, a brother being knocked upside his head or murdered by the fascist police department. That's where it starts. And where it ends with us defending ourselves. We have the Second Amendment right to bear arms and a God-given right to protect ourselves. My mama always told me, don't be no punk. In the just of days, that means there ain't a breathing, living thing on this earth that I should allow to harm me without the consequence of self-defense or defending myself. You know, and that's how we need to take this. You know, there's no such thing as co-opting with the police. You know, they got the recruitment program that they running right now through all out the Bay Area. I know y'all seen it on the radio. You can hop on a BART train and see a recruitment for the police department. Or them co-opting community by doing these community watch meetings and coming to the community and demonizing your very same kids, your brothers, your sisters, your nieces, your nephews. Now all of a sudden these people is monsters. They want your support to militarize. But I see right here today, they don't got our support. They don't. You know, ultimately what needs to happen, we need to mobilize.
Cocktail at the precinct, you know how we think. Organize the hood on the I Ching banners.